Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. I am your Lipa Miss, and again come back with your chemistry class. Today I will discuss about chemical reactions, lesson 7, 8, 9. There are 3 reactions in your book. Today I will discuss about those reactions. At first, reaction 1, burning of magnesium, or you can say combustion of magnesium. You know that magnesium is a metal. So if we burn magnesium, then what do you know? Burning is happening in presence of oxygen gas, isn't it? So when we burn magnesium metal in presence of oxygen, then what reaction will occur there? Magnesium reacts with oxygen and produce a compound, isn't it? And then compound will be magnesium oxide. Here only one compound is produced, because in the reactants only magnesium and oxygen are produced. So only magnesium oxide is produced here. Now let's see. We will use in this reaction as magnesium metal, magnesium ribbon. This is a ribbon made of magnesium. So if we tear small piece of magnesium ribbon, and when we hold this magnesium ribbon piece using a tong in the flame of burner, then follow this picture. Then this magnesium ribbon, when we hold in flame of burner, then it will light more luminously, or it will light more bright, like this way. Actually, this luminous light is the reaction of magnesium burning. Follow this picture. Follow here. Magnesium ribbon, when burning, then this type of more bright or dazzling light we will see. And when the magnesium is burned with oxygen, and already magnesium oxide will produce, in that time that light will not present there. So here this part, this is actually a white ash. We will see there is white ash, and this white ash is nothing, just magnesium oxide. That means here magnesium reacting with oxygen and already produced magnesium oxide, white ash. So this is our actually reaction, burning of magnesium or combustion of magnesium. Now what will be the equation? Follow here. When we burn a piece of magnesium ribbon in air, that is oxygen, then there will produce a product which is magnesium oxide, and the equation will be like this: magnesium plus oxygen arrow magnesium oxide. So when you will write a reaction, then you have to give a language. For example, here you can write, when magnesium ribbon reacts with oxygen, then there is produced magnesium oxide. Like this way you have to write in spelling. And now then you have to write the equation like this way, using formula. So at first you will write the reaction in language, and then you have to say that this reaction is occurring by the following equation, and equation is this short expression of reaction using formula. Follow here. You have to use here formula of magnesium, formula of oxygen molecule, and formula of magnesium oxide. So actually equation is the short form of reaction. Reaction is the expression of reaction in language, and equation is the expression of reaction in shortly using formula. Like this way you have to explain this type of reaction. Now how will you draw the diagram? if in question you have to say they explain the combustion reaction of magnesium, in that case after writing the answer you can draw this diagram. Just simply you draw like this way. This is the flame burner, this is flame and this is tong. Actually we will not hold the magnesium ribbon with our hand. We have to hold this using a tong. This is our available in our laboratory. So when we hold magnesium ribbon, this is our magnesium ribbon, then it will make a dazzling light, that means more bright light, and after the reaction there will be remain magnesium oxide white ash. And this ash, if you just move, then this ash is falling like white powder of magnesium oxide falling like this way. Then you can collect it in a china dish, in a pot. So like this way you can draw the diagram of burning of magnesium ribbon. Now we will know about the reaction 2. Our reaction 2 is reaction between calcium carbonate and hydrochloric acid. Calcium carbonate, this is a chemical substance, and this hydrochloric acid is also a chemical substance. So this is a liquid aqueous solution of aqueous solution, and this is a solid substance. Follow this picture. Here in a test tube, this is a test tube. When you take a test tube and you will take at first some hydrochloric acid, this aqueous solution is the hydrochloric acid. Now if you insert inside the solution hydrochloric acid solution some pieces of calcium carbonate, these are the pieces of calcium carbonate. Here for calcium carbonate we can use many things. For example, chalk. Have you heard chalk? Have you seen chalk white? Actually this chalk we use to write on the blackboard. So this chalk is mainly calcium carbonate. So you also use here the powder of chalk, and also eggshell. Eggshell is fully calcium carbonate. So also you use here eggshell, and also snail, shell of snail. This is also calcium carbonate. Also you use here limestone. Limestone, in Bengali it is called chuna pathor. Limestone is also calcium carbonate. So when you insert some piece of calcium carbonate, then you will see there is creating bubbles. Follow here, there is creating bubbles. These bubbles is of what? These bubbles is of carbon dioxide gas. Why? Because calcium carbonate reacts with hydrochloric acid and there produce calcium chloride, water and carbon dioxide gas. These bubbles are carbon dioxide gas. So this similar experiment you can do using another substance. For example, follow here, eggshell. If we put eggshell inside the hydrochloric acid, also similar type reaction will occur. These are follow here, these bubbles are actually of carbon dioxide gas. Now follow the reaction. How will you write the reaction? If we add small pieces of calcium carbonate such as marbles, marble is stone, not marble made of glass which you play, not marble. This marble is actually marble stone which is mainly used in decoration of building. So these are also fully calcium carbonate. So when we add small pieces of calcium carbonate such as marbles, limestone, eggshell, chalk, etc. in hydrochloric acid, then calcium carbonate reacts with hydrochloric acid and produce calcium chloride, carbon dioxide gas and water by the following equation. Follow here. So this is the reaction, and this is the equation. This language is the reaction. Reaction means what is happening you have to tell in language. And this is the short expression of reaction. Follow here. Calcium carbonate reacts with hydrochloric acid, produce calcium chloride, carbon dioxide gas and water. So You have to write the answer, or you have to explain the reaction like this. At first you have to write reaction, then you have to write equation. Follow here. So these bubbles are for carbon dioxide gas, and you know that carbon dioxide gas is not remaining there. After some time we will see all carbon dioxide gases are vanishes, isn't it? Because the mouth of the test tube is open, so carbon dioxide gas will left out from the test tubes. Then in that time only calcium chloride and water will remain inside the test tube. So like this way this reaction is actually happened. Now we will know there is produced carbon dioxide gas. There is produced carbon dioxide gas. Also we can prove the production of carbon dioxide gas like this way. Follow this figure. If we insert a balloon at the mouth of the here for reaction, used conical flask, not test tube. You can use test tube, you can use any open dish, or also you can use conical flask. These instruments or this apparatus name is conical flask. So if you use any balloon at the mouth of the conical flask, then when the reaction will start, then there is produced what? Calcium chloride, water and carbon dioxide gas. So when this carbon dioxide gas goes upward, then follow here, this carbon dioxide gas actually swallowed the balloons. The size of balloons will be swallowed. So from this experiment it is proved that there is produced a gas. Okay, now how will you draw the diagram? Follow here. Simply you use here conical flask, then just writing like this way, labeling like this way, and this is carbon dioxide gas. There is used cotton, you can use or not, no problem. You can open it, you can kept it open, no problem. Just you have to write and draw the diagram of this reaction. Now I will discuss about reaction 3, reaction between magnesium and hydrochloric acid. So already you have seen hydrochloric acid and magnesium rebound, so you can easily understood what will be the reaction. Follow here. In a test tube, when we will take some hydrochloric acid, and inside the hydrochloric acid, if you use the piece of magnesium ribbon, then also we will see some bubbles. There is creating some bubbles. Follow here. Magnesium ribbon is gradually vanishes, and there is creating more bubbles. Why? Because here magnesium reacts with hydrochloric acid and produce what? Magnesium chloride and hydrogen gas, not carbon dioxide gas, because there is not present carbon in the reactant side. The reactants are what? Magnesium and hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid means hydrogen and chlorine and magnesium. So these three atoms, magnesium, hydrogen and chlorine, they produce magnesium chloride and hydrogen gas, not any carbon dioxide or any other gases. So now follow the reactions. If we add a small piece of magnesium ribbon in hydrochloric acid, then magnesium reacts with hydrochloric acid and produce magnesium chloride and hydrogen gas by the following equation. Follow here. This is the equation of this reaction. So like this way you have to explain, and also similar experiment you can do using another metals. For example, zinc, iron, lead. Similar type reaction will occur. So, and in that case, equation will be changed like this way. Zinc reacts with hydrochloric acid, produce zinc chloride and hydrogen. When iron reacts with hydrochloric acid, produce ferrous chloride plus hydrogen. When lead reacts with hydrochloric acid, produce lead chloride plus hydrogen gas. So, like this way, you have to explain these three reactions. I hope you can easily understand. And you have to write and you have to practice the reaction and equation perfectly. Okay, so today up to this. In next class I will come back new topic. So up to that, Be well and stay safe. Goodbye.